Dear friends, my name is Venkat Shivakumar. I'm a chartered accountant in practice, and also I've done a master's in constitutional law. And I've been practicing, I'm also a resolution professional. And this series of lectures is on performance appraisal of the insolvency and bankruptcy court. You are aware that recently in one interview, Mr. Prashant Kishore, you all know, a very capable person, strategist, elections, told about Mr. Modi, the Honorable Prime Minister of our country. He said that I understood from his interview that Honorable Prime Minister is trying his best to work. The nation believes that Honorable Prime Minister is a dedicated person. But however, a lot of things are failing because the administration is not in supportive of his efforts. And therefore, it is the duty of every citizen and intellectuals to do their bit in supporting the efforts of the Honorable Prime Minister. In that aspect, I have been practicing as a resolution professional also from the day one. The code was enacted in 2016 in December, and it started functioning better from June 2017. So I was I've been appearing in the NCLT all over India, and also I filed one petition bill for constitution of NCLAT in Chennai that has come. And with the experience gained, I've been watching that this is a very, very powerful economic legislation, and government, the parliament has given full support to this functioning of this legislation. The Honorable Supreme Court also has given very good support. Because most of the judgments, if you see, the Honorable Supreme Court wanted to make this work. So they debarred all other courts from interfering. High Court has no jurisdiction. Only NCLT, the first tribunal, and then appellate body, NCLAT, principal bench situated in Delhi, and then Supreme Court. So, from the government's point of view, the legislature gave full support to IBBI, and to make the things work, because this is of a very, very important economic legislation. Honorable Prime Minister came out with demonetization with great hopes that we can capture a lot of black money, and you all know it has become a big failure. And not only the entire, more than the money available has come back, and it has broken the backbone of our economy, of our nation. But the intention of the Prime Minister is under nobody's question. And then this legislation is thought of to bring very good realizations to the banks. But then at the end of the 3 years, where do we stand? Why do we? So here the discussion is going to be what should have happened and what has happened. I will take you to the background of international laws, etc., etc. So the point is very clear. I will summarize. I've been a teacher. I've been training more than 2 lakh students, chartered accountancy students. Teaching was my profession. Therefore, I would like to summarize every 5 minutes what I teach. So this particular lecture, what we spoke so far is that it is a very important economic legislation. And the background to this also, when Raghuram Rajan was the chairman of the Reserve Bank governor, he, 2013, he thought, he declared NPAs were 2,50,000 crores. And he felt that this figure is wrong because top managements in collusion with the other persons are understating the bad debts. And therefore, he himself wanted to do a checking. When he appointed some investigators, and he came to know the losses are more than 7,50,000 crores. Then this legislation was thought of to be a very important legislation to help the banks in recovering that money, which is already written off. Larger amounts were such significant amount was written off, because this is 7,50,000 crores is not somebody's money. It is the tax-paying honest people's money that has to be used. Every penny is important. That is the background. So the government, the prime minister, was highly committed to the success of this legislation. One. And Supreme Court was also giving benefit of doubt to this for functioning. Let us see, give a chance for this. And all the previous legislations are found to be disastrous. So in this background, we have to analyze what happened. The jurisprudence was developing. Several amendments were made almost on a 15-day basis were there. And so far as I'm concerned, I have been informing the suggestions I was making to Ministry of Corporate Affairs and also IBBI. And you know the Honorable Chairman of IBBI, Mr. Dr. Saul, almost on a regular basis, he was on the media. And he's a very nice gentleman, very pleasant and polite. But then he never replied to me. And he was not entertaining any discussion with the resolution professionals, or the key persons. And today, I filed a petition for NCLAT in Chennai. And you know that it has been sanctioned and is about to start. But then because of the COVID, it's not come. But then it should come by June. Now we are in April end. And I also filed a petition because I have not got any response from the IBBI. I have not got any response from Ministry of Corporate Affairs. I have also sent a lot of letters to Honorable Prime Minister on the how to revive this. And as of today, if you see, dear friends, when you started, we had 7,50,000 crores of NPAs when this act was enacted. And today what happened, if you see the reports of Business Standard, Economic Times, series of national news media, that we have lost 6,50,000 crores of money has been written off. That is hard-earned public money has been completely wiped out. And then out the 8.2 lakh crores, what they say, a recent report in Business Line says, a week back, that 1.7 lakh crores of rupees is resolved. Actually, resolved means normal people are understanding that it is money has come to banks. It is not resolution means the promoter will go, another promoter will come, and he will promise the banks. Suppose the bank has given the banks, Indian public sector banks have given 1,000 crores. The new man says, I will take this company for 100 crores. That means 900 crores is written off. But that 100 crores is not given. He may be giving 10 crores of rupees upfront payment. And he promises to pay the balance 90 crores by way of running the business. So we are under the impression that you got too much of money for the banks. Even 1,70,000 crores is not come. So, I am going to see with due respect, it is not that you should not get the impression that things are, things are bad. Every statement that I am going to make is supported by data. And it is not to make a sweeping, everybody must be working hard to make it perform. But finally, the question is performance appraisal and why these people have failed. And that is the purpose of this lecture. So I repeat, when the code was introduced with an intention to recover the 7,50,000 crores of rupees in a time-bound manner. And this legislation cannot be compared with the other legislations because this is a very powerful legislation. It could have been made, we could have recovered 5 lakh crores easily, is my opinion. I'm going to justify that. And that is the basis why I'm before this lecture. Just trying to discuss various issues where the IBBI, Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board, has failed, miserably failed, is my opinion. And let us see what is that reply they will be giving to us. So, of course, the issue that we are going to take up for discussion is what should have happened and what did happen. You understand? Using this legislation, we could have saved at least 5 lakh crores, is my contention. Now the summary of the performance of this various reports just published in the month of April 2020, means after a period of 36 plus months. First is 8.2 lakh crores of rupees is the NPS as on date. Of this, 6.5 lakh crores is lost, 0.1. Which means about 1.7 lakh crores is assumed to be resolved. And 1.1 million jobs lost. Even resolved means is not the money received. It is only a change of promoters from one old promoters who are considered to be delinquent. They are not able to run. So as a result of which another person has come and taken over. We don't know how he's going to perform. And what will be, what are his promises and the next 5 years, whether he's going to fulfill them or not. And in total, out of the total cases admitted for resolution, only 6% of them have been solved. And all the others have gone in for liquidation. And one simple example, 250 companies went for liquidation, where the banks, public sector banks, have exposure of 9,600 crores, only 16 crores have come. Only 16 crores have been realized. And now, the time duration is almost running to 400 days. So what is the object with which the code has been enacted? I'll just roughly talk. I'll take the what law the Supreme Court has mentioned. The first step is it is a time-bound resolution. And second step is maximum realization to creditors. And third step is to keep the concern as a going concern. And only when you keep it as a going concern, you will find a recovery is better. Maximum realization is possible. And this is to be kept as the going concern concept is there are three stages in the resolution. First one is the CIR, the corporate insolvency resolution process, where there is a default is noticed and the promoters in control is lost and the creditors in control comes into the picture. And then it is run through one resolution professional who should make the best efforts to ensure that the resolution is found. That means new promoter will come. And what happens is in this process of CIRP, new resolution professional comes. Say 400 crores is the loan of the financial creditors, etc. And then that fellow will come for 100 crores. So 300 crores is a haircut. But that 100 crores is not bringing 10 crores he will give upfront payment. Balance 90 crores he will say I'll pay over a staggered period of sometimes 5 years like this. So we don't know whether that is itself failed at that point is not there. Now, let's go through what is the claim of this insolvency and bankruptcy court. This is the regulator. They are the people. You can see they have published one note, miscellany of perspectives. Mr. Sahu is the face of Dr. Sahu is the face of insolvency and bankruptcy court. A handsome person, very soft and gentleman. But then here we are evaluating how we perform, because we know only this gentleman, nothing else, nobody is, all our officials, is a bureaucratic organization. And let us see what their point of view. See, these are the goals. What are the goals given to them? You need maximum realization to creditors, point one. Point number two, in a time-bound manner, agreed. And resolution should be given priority. That means during the CIRP period, you have to keep the entity as a going concern. In case something goes wrong and it goes to liquidation, then first preference is to be given for compromise arrangement under section 236. There also going concern. Even in liquidation, regulation 32 UAE says that you keep the entity as a going concern. So going concern is the basic structure of the law. Now what I'm trying to see is, I'm not going into all those points, because this is a legislation where there was a complete support from the government. And Mr. Modi has taken it as a great commitment to ensure that something, because so many lakhs of crores which will be used for poor, this money is not somebody's money, taxpaying public's money. So why it has, whether it has failed or not, first point is I'm saying it is failed. And we let us see what they're saying. And the data I've already produced to you. Now only everybody's talking. All these 3 years, every new media was writing good about it, because this involves huge money, thousands of crores of rupees. So I'm now talking from the angle of what should have been achieved and what is achieved. I think that 6.5 lakh crores lost, we could have saved at least 5 lakh crores of rupees, if not more. So whether I'm right or wrong, I've already told you that I've been writing letters to them last 2 years. I filed a public interest litigation which is pending. It's supposed to come for hearing. And also I filed a bill for NCLAT, principal bench only, Delhi is there. It's come now here. Not yet started functioning because of this COVID. So with all this background, we are now going to see broadly this. What did he say in this? If you see page number 3, A Journey of Endless Hope is the article written by Mr. Dr. Sahu. And Dr. Sahu is the face of the IBBI, and he has been on media almost on a weekly basis giving reports, talking to them. Where nation believes that this IBC has done extremely well. And ease of doing business, which is 143, it's come to 63. And Dr. Sahu claims it's only because of insolvency and bankruptcy court. Yesterday, Honorable Judge of Supreme Court, Mr. Ram Subramani, while talking about the Arbitration and Conciliation Act, he also mentioned that that act also claims, because of the Arbitration Act, that ease of doing business has come down. There also he raised, beautifully analyzed, that in one example he was telling that arbitral tribunals, when the claim is 674 crores of rupees in one case, that man claimed 8,000 crores as the damages and he got it. That is because of the, he didn't say directly, but when you read that, it is all because of the corruption of the ministry, the government departments. All that he mentioned was why this much of loss for the nation should be dealt with, especially government contracts, such a huge loss is being incurred, that some research data is not published. So here also, the Journey of Endless Hope, where Dr. Sahu tried to justify this performance of the court as one of the best performers without any data. I would like to, before I read this, I would like to tell you, Mr. Dr. Sahu has said that 2 lakh crores of rupees have been saved. That is, people who wanted to file cases. Mere threat of filing case or issuing notice to the corporate debtor, the money was solved. Then last week, about 10 days back, Injati Srinivas, Honorable Secretary of Ministry of Corporate Affairs, has said that 3 trillion rupees have been recovered because of this insolvency and bankruptcy code on mere filing of the case under Section 7 or 9. Now, I have actually filed a bill for that. I sent a RTI. Asked them, what is the data on which you people have come to this conclusion that 2 lakh crores you are saying to IBBI. Then IBBI sent me back, no such claim. We don't have any such data. So most of the policies that are being taken by IBBI and are basically driven by no data. Scientific research data is missing. That's what Honorable Ram Subramanian Jay, with regard to corporate this Arbitration Act, Reconciliation Act 1996, was telling that there should be some research why this is all happening, because that will be the guiding point for taking our decisions.